Around 100 workers met with their union to discuss its response to growing poverty and inequality in New Zealand. The first union is currently in the middle of wage bargaining with four major retail companies. But because inflation is low, it's getting very low offers of wage increases. It wants to see companies take notice of the living wage, an amount calculated by an independent group of economists at $18.40 an hour.
We're really pushing on companies to come to the party rather than paying, you know, pathetic wage increases of 1% or 2% to try and get those minimum wages that they are paying up to a realistic living wage level.
The union is striving for decent wage increases, and it says just because inflation is low or the cost of living index is low, it doesn't mean it will accept low wage increases.
In fact, this is the ideal time to be able to give more increases because other costs that employers face are also low at this stage.
Members were encouraged to sign a pledge to show their commitment. They'll work with the union to campaign for not only a living wage, but safe work conditions and fair employment laws. It wants local MPs to know there are workers in this city who are concerned about proposed changes to employment laws, low wages and inequality.
The better of those politicians, hopefully, will work with us to change that. And the ones who don't want to do that, I guess we'll be saying, you just get out of the road, because workers in this country are not just going to stand for these poverty wages and growing inequality forever.
The union will be visiting 50 groups right across the country and presenting signed pledge posters to local MPs. Dee Karen, 39 Dunedin News.